Be my boo boo, be my injury, be that cut on my arm, be that scrape on my knee. Be my boo boo, be my injury, be that cut on my arm, be that scrape on my knee.
I started writing songs when I was about 7, and then I learned guitar a little bit when I was around 12, 13, when there was a big 80s hair band movement. That was my calling, to start learning guitar, do my duty in life. And then I put down the guitar, actually, for some time. I was pretty, like, I was into just doing it alone. I didn't really have people around me that listened to the same music I did or wanted to play any instruments at all with me. Because I got kicked out of band when I was in high school. I couldn't read music or anything. Right. So, you know, as much as I searched for people to play with, they just weren't really there. So I decided to go play softball, and that's when I did that for several years, and, you know, went to college and played sports in college, and then after all that cycle of life, sports, then came back into music somehow, so, which is probably about 3 or 4 years ago, I think now, so, yeah, okay. Four. Yeah.
So what kind of subjects were you writing about at 7?
Anything that would make my friends laugh. So you can imagine, you know, sounds and food and
defecation.
And dogs. And, yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Those type of songs. I've grown out of that.
Poop songs.
I've definitely grown out of that, and now I'm into more spiritual songs and just a lot of love and a lot of kind of God talk, actually, which is surprising to me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So. Were you raised in a religious way?
Somewhat. My father is a minister.
Okay, then yes.
Yeah.
That would be the answer to that.
Yeah, I was, but he wasn't so, you know, he wasn't like a helicopter parent. You know, he wasn't, you know, like, you have to do this, you have to do that. But I definitely went to church, and he was always very accepting of me as, you know, his gay daughter and things like that. So I never had some, you know, issues as far as the gay stuff goes with with religion. So.
And did you come out rather early then, like as a young kid, or
I didn't, because I just kind of, you know, I was running around bases. And
they assumed once you put on that baseball outfit, that was
they probably did. No, but I just had fun with different people.
Yeah,
back then.
Is that what they called them back then? Fun with different people. Note to self.
Okay.
Well, this is something we leave in, maybe.
But no. Then I came out in college. I must have been 19-ish or something like that. And then
that's pretty young. That's great. Good for you.
Yeah, yeah. But they were both sets of parents. Everyone was just okay.
Mistaking me for some damn fool who likes it rough. You can twist it, you can turn it. No, you can't break me. Cause I got a glow in my soul. Yeah, it's making me scream. So take.
Play on your recordings? Like, do you play everything?
Yeah, on Don't Be My Boo Boo, which that's when I have a video for, that is, it's all me. So there's probably about 5 different voices. So I go really low, go really high, and then in between, and then I'll make these weird sounds and things like that.
Yeah,
but that's vocals and yeah, I had bass, keys, electric guitar, acoustic guitar. I don't think acoustic was on Don't Be My Boo Boo, but yeah. So that was all me. And same with Availability, too. That one, I played acoustic guitar, electric guitar, bass, and all the vocals, too. So
that's impressive.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's really good.
It's fun. It's like that's where the magic happens. That's like the fun of it. It's whatever happens after that, it's out of my control. But but that's like the, you know, I feel like I'm being my best in the world. So. And I was just in traffic getting to her, and we were going to discuss what the concept was going to be, and then all of a sudden it came to me, and I was just like, I'm going to be on the ground, and I'm going to be, you know, there's going to be a bandana over my face, my eyes, you know, it's going to cover that, then people are going to be grabbing me and touching me, and they're going to try to capture me, and then you're my best friend, you're going to come grab me and, you know, and take care of me and bring me to safety, and there's going to be glow sticks and dogs and things like that. So,
because there must be glow sticks and dogs.
Yeah, exactly. That makes the video. Gotta have my furry friend in the video.
That's great.
So we did that and shared it with the director, Robin. She's pretty awesome, and she, you know, had her spin on things too and made it. She just brought it to life, which is great. So as far as all the colors and the real personalities of the two gangs, she brought that out. So it was fun.
Yeah.
Fun video to shoot.
It was excellent.
A lot of great people involved, and I'm very thankful for everyone who's in there.
Be my boo boo. Be my injury. Be that cut on my arm. Be that scrape on my knee. Be my boo boo. Be my injury. Be that cut on my arm. Be that scrape on my knee.
No, I love LA. LA's got some great things to it. It's got my friends there. It's got great creative energy and things like that. It gets, you know, tiring sometimes. I was just talking to my wonderful girlfriend about this, but just the self-motivating part of, I mean, I think that's in the music industry anywhere probably right now for us independent artists, but it gets really tiring day in and day out to be, you know, that. So, especially when I'm doing a lot of these songs on my own too, like each corner of it, then I don't have that team, which when I was playing sports, I relied on that team to keep me up and to, you know, just be there to say positive things. So it's a lot of positive self-talk and stuff that's gotten me this far. And so I just, you know, kind of need some breaks here and there to make sure I keep going.
Yeah, that's the whole point, right?
yeah, so. But LA, the whole place, Los Angeles, can be kind of tiring sometimes. But I think it's just that energy of I got to do my best all the time.
Absolutely. Now, I know you're a pretty private person, but relationship, no relationship? What's going on right now?
Oh, yes. I have an awesome relationship.
Yeah, good. Yeah. Okay, so she's unavailable. All right, that's good to know. How long has it been?
In the relationship?
Yeah.
Oh, it's been probably about 1.5 years going on 30.
Yeah. So this is pretty serious then.
It's very excellent. Serious, but she's pretty great. She knows exactly, you know, how to handle me. And I know I'm different because I consider myself two-spirited too. Mm-hmm. And so when I go through my masculine and feminine swings and sways, she knows how to handle that stuff. And that's important. Right. It's not just a gay thing anymore.
Yes, that's
true. It's a spirit thing.
Be my injury. Be that cut on my arm. Be that scrape on my knee. Be my boo boo. Be my injury. Be that cut on my arm. Be that scrape on my knee. I was not my favorite type of.
You're quite an interesting mixture of hairband lover and country music maker as well.
Yeah.
So tell us about the love of the hairband. I want to hear about that. Who's your fave?
Yeah, oh, Bon Jovi. For sure.
Yeah.
For sure.
He's the
by
one.
Far. Anyone that knows me knows it's definitely Bon Jovi. But just the positive, you know, songs that they wrote.
Yeah.
They also weren't afraid to say the word God in their songs too, which I found, you know, I didn't see them in the other hair bands. But
yeah, that's
except Stryper. But the Christian rock band. But I think that, and I think what probably also attracted me to them is just their, you know, they were men in makeup, so that kind of transgenderish look, and I think that's kind of more of my nature, being two-spirited, is having both, you know, kind of characteristics, so I think that's my tribe, of those people, so that's, 80s hair bands, they're the best, But so now to translate that into 2011 is, you know, that type of songwriting has been, you know, country rock, I think, now more. So that's what comes out of me. And even though when I first started writing country songs, I was kind of embarrassed.
To tell your friends?
Well, I was embarrassed of the sounds coming out of my mouth. And I was embarrassed of, like, the strumming I was doing and things like that. And I was just like, what is that sound?
It's a boom chick thing going on down there.
Yeah, and just the twang. I was just like, what is going on? And then I just was like, just honor it and just make sure it comes out. And then just the more I just honor what comes to me, it makes everything easier.
Yeah.
So.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's good.
Good.